everyone, my name is Katie and I like to inspire creativity and confidence through DIY and style. And today on my channel we are tackling the project of recreating three pieces of artwork that I found online that I really, really liked, but I couldn't quite justify spending the amount of money that they cost. Now, a disclaimer here, I am not that good at fine art. This is not my area of expertise. So I tried to pick three that were pretty simple for me to follow. So I think that if you have any level of art skill, it doesn't matter, you can definitely achieve this. And I think they turned out pretty comparable to the pictures online. So if you guys like this type of video, make sure that you are subscribed to my channel and let's go ahead and get started. So my first piece of advice whenever you are recreating any artwork is to get your frames at Goodwill or your local thrift store, whatever you have in your area. It's pretty easy to find old frames there, and even if they're not the right color, you can always paint them, stain them, whatever you need to do. They're so much cheaper than you would find at a craft store or any other store, so definitely do that first. So I found this Taylor Swift poster in a gold frame at Goodwill for $4.99. Now I do love me some T-Swift, don't get me wrong, but for $4.99 this frame was perfect. In hindsight, I wish I had gone with something a little higher quality just because it ended up being plastic and it was kind of difficult to get apart, but for $4.99 it was totally worth it. So I just took some time to pull that apart, get the cardboard out. If you're using a regular frame, all you need to do is paint it gold or spray paint it. And then I also picked up this piece of artboard that I found at Michael's, and it turned out to be the exact same size as the glass of the frame. So I was really excited about that. I didn't have to do any cutting or anything like that. So I used my phone with the picture on it for reference. So this is from Anthropologie and it sells for $248. So like I said, fine art is not my area of expertise, but I did my best and I just took a pencil and drew out the trunks of each palm tree, and they turned out a little bit squiggly, but they're not actually perfect in the actual painting on Anthropologie either, so I thought it would be just fine. Then I just used the edge of my paintbrush and some black paint and then just drew and filled in where I had drawn those lines. And then for the palm fronds, I just kind of used the bottom corner and just sort of did these little wispy strokes and left the ends not perfect, just so that it looks like they're blowing in the breeze. And yeah, I just kind of followed this pattern all the way around the palm tree and used the bristles to create that effect at the bottom of the leaves. So this was really, really simple. I just popped my frame back together and, like I said, wish I'd gone with a little higher quality. I ended up having to glue this together a bit, but then I just slid my painting in once it was dry. And so for about, I guess, probably $15, I was able to recreate this, and I think it looks pretty good. Next up is this watercolor from West Elm, which sells for $99. Now, I already had the watercolor set because I love watercolor, but it just costs a couple dollars at the craft store, and then this artboard, which costs about $5. So I'm just using a wider brush here than I normally would to watercolor because it's taking me less time and it's also giving me the look that I want to go for from the original. So this is really just all about mixing and matching and blending colors to achieve the same color as the original. I pulled it up on my phone again just for a reference. Sometimes I would blot it with a paper towel if I thought that was the look that I needed to go for. But this is really just about sort of copycatting what you find. And then I found this frame from Goodwill for about $5. Again, it was silver, so I spray painted it white. But all in all, this project cost me about $10 to $15 compared to the $99 that was selling online. This one is by far the most simple. The original is from Urban Outfitters and the 8x10 costs $40. So I just picked up these paints that were each about $1 to $2. I tried to match the colors as closely as possible, and then I used a couple different sizes of brushes to make these paint strokes. Like I said, it is very simple. You just have to paint down the paper in each color. A couple of them had some variations, like this next color kind of had an unfinished brushstroke look at the bottom, so I used the bottom corner of my brush to achieve that look. And then for the next one, for this pink, I used a bit of a wider brush, and then it had this little sort of gap in the paint at the bottom, so again I used the corner of my brush to recreate that. But yeah, it's very simple. You just need to make sure you're following along closely looking at the original, and I love this one. I found this frame for, again, I think it was $3.99, and I really like the color blue, so I kept it as is. But again, this project cost me about $10 to $15 to make, which is a big steal compared to the original. Enjoyed seeing my take on those, and they were pretty simple, right? Let me know in the comments below which one was your favorite, and I hope you will try at least one of them out, maybe all of them, and let me know how it goes if you do by posting your pictures on Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and to give this video a big old thumbs up, and I will see you guys next week for a brand new video.